Do you think it's okay to glue your acrylic together with super glue? Do you think it's acceptable to use tape to put acrylic together? Do you think it's okay to glue your acrylic together with hot glue? Then this video is not for you. My name is Eric Stebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. Some good basic tools for working with acrylic are a nice good steel ruler, an acrylic scoring blade, some solvent, stepper bits work really good for drilling holes, a file, some sandpaper, and then a good way to dispense the solvent. You can use a brush, but I like to use something with a needle like this Lure Lock bottle, link below. Here's a sheet of blue extruded acrylic. It has a slightly lower melting temperature than the cast acrylic, but perfectly suitable for any model building project. Cast acrylic usually has a paper backing on it, that's how you can tell the difference. It has a higher melting temperature and is usually a little bit harder than the extruded acrylic. It comes in many colors, including translucent, transparent, like the clear, and of course, many colors, like this sheet of black. It comes in rods and tubes as well, in many different sizes for whatever your needs are. This video assumes that you don't have access to a laser cutter. We're going to build three different cubes using three different methods, using various equipment and machinery from basic to intermediate skill level. All right. To attempt any sort of model building project, you need some sort of a plan. So just like in many of my other videos, we're going to draw out a plan. We're going to make a 2-inch cube. This is equal to 50.8 millimeters. You also need to know the thickness of your material. And in this case, we're going to use 2.4 millimeter thick material. We're going to put end caps on our cube. It's going to have basically a top and a bottom. We're going to have overlapping sides, so you'll see two of them here. Overlapping means that the height will be slightly different than the width on the sides of the cube. So let's calculate the height of the side pieces that we're going to make. We can calculate that by taking the 50.8 minus 2.4 minus 2.4. This gives us 46 millimeters in height. So next we need to figure out the width of the sides. We can figure this out by taking 50.8 minus 2.4. This gives us 48.4 on the width of each of the sides. Now for the end caps, those should be square, so they should be 50.8 by 50.8. Let's build the first two cubes using this method. All right, the first cube we're gonna build, we're gonna use building a bandsaw. And you would think that this is maybe the easiest or the best way to cut some acrylic to build a cube. Let's try. The first issue you're going to run into is saw marks, and these saw marks come from the bandsaw itself. So I file and sand the edges of all the pieces of acrylic to get them out. Next, let's cut the four sides. I've cut a few extra, and I pick out the four that are the closest in size. Clamp them together and start filing out those saw marks as well. Try to get them all uniform. Now, let's cut the top and the bottom parts. Now that we have the two end caps cut, let's drill a hole. I'm going to use a regular drill bit. Notice how I have a piece of wood underneath my piece of acrylic. This is important so you don't get chip out at the back side. Nice and slow, easy does it, gets you a really nice hole with a stepper bit. Next, I'll bandsaw off a little piece of acrylic rod, and that's what we will adhere onto the end of the cube. Let's talk about solvents. I'm using Weldon's Water Clear Fast Set Dichloromethane. I'm taking it out of the main container with a syringe, and I'm putting it into this Lure Lock application bottle. This is what I'm going to use to adhere one piece of acrylic to another. Let's do a little flood weld. So I'm just flooding the area and placing the other piece of acrylic right on top of that. And that melts the acrylic. So when I'm using this needle here to place little drops of fluid onto the acrylic, it's softening and melting the acrylic on a molecular level. And this allows the acrylic to then bond to another piece of acrylic. It makes a very strong bond after about 12 to 24 hours. I'm sanding the cube flat so I can put the end caps on. Notice I'm using a 30 gauge needle here in this lure lock bottle applicator. It's very fine because the solvent is very, very thin, and this allows me to place just a little bit of solvent exactly where I need the solvent to be to start softening the acrylic so I can bond the two pieces together. Let's add a weight on the top just to help. And now let's glue in the 3/8 clear rod into the hole that we've drilled and place just a tiny bit of solvent along the bottom edge and connect those. The solvent will evaporate eventually, and it'll create an excellent bond. We'll peel away the paper and our cube will be finished. The parts for this cube were cut with a bandsaw, which means you have saw marks that you have to remove somehow, so not my first choice for building models with acrylic. Let's take a look at some other options. Let's build the second cube with an acrylic scoring blade. You can buy these at your local big box retailer for less than $10. This blade has a hook on it that will score a V groove in your plastic, and you can drag that against a ruler to create your break line. You'll do this several times to create a nice groove in your acrylic. You can then take your acrylic and snap it. You want to grab onto the fatter piece of acrylic so you get better leverage to break it. Let's clamp that piece of acrylic along that score line on the edge of the table, and that's it. I'm going to use an X-Acto knife to cut through the plastic that's on the outside, and you get a pretty clean break. The nice thing about this method is you don't have to come back and clean up any saw marks like you do on the bandsaw, and you don't have acrylic chips flying all over the place. You'll notice I've cut quite a few strips, and now I'm cutting perpendicular to that strip to make my little side pieces. And of course, I'm going to make extra ones so that I can choose the four that are the closest in size to make it a little bit easier for me to make my cube. So the snap and score method gives you a pretty clean cut, a very clean break, and you don't have to go back and clean up those edges like you do with the bandsaw. You use the same solvent as we did to make the first cube. This is a 14 gauge needle, much too fat of a needle to dispense the liquid here. So let's put the 30 gauge needle back onto the dispenser and try that again. All right, you see how that solvent wicks underneath the piece of acrylic? That's what you want. Once the initial flood of solvent has evaporated, you can come back and add a little bit more just to soften up the plastic and create a little bit of a stronger bond. I'm going to go ahead and cement the rest of the corners of this clear snap and score cube together using the same method. Again, flooding underneath just those overlapping joints. Use some 180 grit sandpaper to sand my cube flat, and a little bit of air to blow off that dust. I'm applying a solvent on the edges of my top piece and placing my cube down on there, and you can see the solvent being wicked underneath there. Whether you do it from the top or the bottom, the result is the same. This is a little bit of an easier cube to build. Accuracy is probably not quite as high as the bandsaw, but an easy, clean way to work and build models with acrylic. The third way I'm going to build a cube is to use a table saw, and this will give us a higher degree of dimensional accuracy than the other two methods we've used so far. I'm using a cross-cut 60-tooth cutoff blade here. They do make special plastic blades, and mine says for plastic on the side. Basically, the blade has a lot more teeth so that you don't get as much tear out when the saw cuts through the plastic. You'll see that I've attached a board to my fence, and this allows me better control and to get my fingers in there to hold the smaller pieces of plastic than it would against the taller fence. You'll see here, these pieces are all dimensionally identical because they were cut on the saw. All the square faces are 50.8 millimeters, so they are perfectly square. We're going to use a router with a 45 degree bit to bevel each one of the four edges on each of the surfaces. So the router does a really nice job of beveling those edges. There's no tear out. This gives us a really nice surface to use our solvent on to adhere the parts to each other. And it's just a matter of going through and gluing all the beveled edges together to build a cube. I'm using the same solvent here that I used for the other cubes. You could use the thickened acrylic cement here if you wanted and apply it with a brush. I just prefer to use the solvent thinner cement to build my acrylic models with. Building a cube with a table saw and a router and then beveling the edges is going to give you the highest degree of accuracy, the cleanest, best looking cube that you can build. Now, not everybody's going to have a table saw to build a cube like this, so you may end up using one of the other methods, but I want to cover all the different options if you're just starting out and building basic models with acrylic. Each of the methods have their own advantages and disadvantages. In the next video, Advanced Basics, we'll cover using heat to heat bend, drape form, and flame polish our acrylics. Stay tuned for that. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.